Imagine one of those high stress situations. Your heart's pumping, maybe you're hyperventilating and your palms are sweaty. I'm holding a $50 phone bill and I can't open it. A lousy $50 and I'm having anxiety and panic attacks opening the mail. It was the straw that broke the camel's back. 180 degrees from a time in my childhood where there was five cars in the driveway for two adults, a childhood with a thriving family business where things were grand, Christmas gift openings lasted forever, years of plenty. Instead, it flashed me back to the dark days that followed and all of the loss, financial disaster, divorce, and lives that scattered completely to the wind, from riches to rags in a few short years. In fact, they cut off the gas in our house before the foreclosure. I moved half a dozen times in a few short years. Before all was said and done, I was homeless. Not at sleeping in a car or a shelter homeless, but without a home. Living in the basement on a charity of a friend. A mattress on a basement floor with all of my belongings in a few boxes. That envelope to me was overwhelming anxiety, all wrapped up neatly for someone who has spent 20 years building a successful financial planning practice. The unbelievable irony. Now, to be fair, my business was facing some obstacles, but we weren't going to lose everything. My rational brain knew that. It knows bank balances, it knows savings, it knows that we're a two-income family. If I could have caught my breath, it might have recognized that regardless of what business threw at me, we'd be fine. Unfortunately, my rational brain never got a word in edgewise. Fear, anxiety, panic completely took over. Logic, reason, and rational thought were banished and nowhere to be found. So how does a financial planner with lots of experience and a comfortable life hit that wall? The reality is I understand on a fundamental level what flat broke feels like, and there's not a chance I ever want to go back. So self-preservation and life support functions were screaming danger signs. When my business felt vulnerable and unpredictable, I couldn't hunker down to fight. I did a flight into flashbacks and I collapsed in fear, anxiety, and depression, and I could barely function. With help, I was able to recognize that the fear had taken over far too many decisions. When all of the pieces were laid out, I was able to see that it had been driving decisions about all kinds of things for decades. For me, the fear and risk aversion had controlled me and kept me from numerous incredible opportunities throughout my life, and it was time to take that control back. So where are things now? There's no panic over a $50 phone bill. Unless it happens to be the overage charges on my teenager's cell phone bill, and that's an entirely different issue.